5,500 miles from Las Vegas at the U.S. Embassy in Tokyo, an auditorium full of Japanese students watches the final presidential debate.
Clinton or Trump?
Clinton.
Donald Trump just like insults someone, like other people.
Clinton is, I think, well, she has some mistakes like email problems, but I think she has the ability and competency to become a president.
And Trump?
No, never.
Their views are in line with polls showing most Japanese prefer Clinton over Trump. Japan relies heavily on the U.S. for defense, trade, and investment, all things Trump has promised to shake up if he's elected president.
Nobody knows what's going to happen.
Political analyst Kumi Yokoi wrote the book Collapsing America: The World Will Go Mad If There Is President Trump.
The world will go mad. Why did you write that?
I want to show to Japanese your America is breaking.
In Japan, public interest in the U.S. election is high. Almost two dozen Japanese books focus on the prospect of a Trump presidency.
This book says Trump will destroy U.S.-Japan relations, but not everyone here agrees. Some think his policies will actually make Japan stronger.
At this mock debate in Tokyo last week, Trump supporters made their case.
Donald Trump's plan to reinvigorate the U.S. economy will be beneficial for Japan in the long run because a strong U.S. equals a strong Japan.
At the U.S. Embassy in Tokyo, Ambassador Caroline Kennedy spoke of the importance of presidential debates.
And it's hard to describe how much is riding on the candidate's performance and how sometimes the small things matter almost as much or even more than the big issues. Honored that you're.
It's a topic she knows personally.
If we fail, then freedom fails.
Her father, John F. Kennedy's performance in America's first televised debate in 1960 helped him beat Richard Nixon and win the White House. 56 years later, in 2016, the world is watching how this final presidential debate will shape the U.S. election and the course of history. Will Ripley, CNN, Tokyo.
On behalf of women's rights, on behalf of the rights of the LGBT.